Good afternoon or evening, Madam Speaker.
Good evening, sir.
I'm told that I was the last one on the list. Is that true?
No, it is not, sir.
Oh, the name must have added since I was told that. But in any case, I rise to make some comments. I've certainly listened to all the comments that were made by my predecessors, and they were all great comments, and the suggestions that this is not the end but a step in the process are should be taken to heart. I do want to share a story that's rather personal for me. I grew up in West Haven, Connecticut, and I went to school, college in New Haven. And I lived in the, what would be considered the ghetto of New Haven. I lived on Congress, right off of Congress Avenue on Ward Street. And I saw every day the effects of opioid addiction, heroin addiction, and abuse. I saw what it did to the families. I saw how it destroyed people. And it was very close to me. My roommates, some of my roommates were experimenting with heroin at the time. One of them overdosed and was admitted to Yale Hospital and nearly died. My own mother was a victim of opioid abuse. She was a she had a car accident that resulted in very heavy injury to her, and it started with Tylenols and Percodan usage, and it grew to the point where she became dependent on it. And then I would say there were many a day where we had to be very careful with my mom because she really did not know what she was doing. When I left my senior year to go investigate a college in the South, I went to Murray State University for a weekend to talk with the folks there about possibly attending the university. On the way home, my mom and dad had separated a couple years earlier. My mom was living in New York City. So I stopped off, made a phone call from a phone booth, and there was no answer. So then I called home, where my father's house, and my sister, who had lived with my mom, answered the phone. I knew immediately when she answered the phone from my father's house that something wasn't right. So I asked her what happened. She began to cry. And then she told me that my mom had passed away that day because she was on Tylenol and Percocets, and she fell and she hit her head on a piece of furniture and she died. So this is very personal to me. And as I listen to this, I'm so happy that legislation has come forward that addresses the ability to save lives. And we should be congratulated as a body for doing that. But we should also note that this problem has been going on in our cities and our urban areas with the poor and the unfortunate for many, many years before it began to affect the suburban areas. And it's great that we're getting around to doing something about it now, but I wish we had done something about it then. And I would suggest going forward, we should look at those things that afflict the poor and afflict the unfortunate in our cities, and we should address the problems there before they explode into the suburban areas and begin to affect all the demographics. So again, I applaud the work being done, and I think we have a lot more work to do. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I'd like to associate my very brief remarks with Representative Ferraro. I believe he hit the nail on the head. I'm glad to see us here today dealing with this epidemic that's been going on in our communities and our state and our country for a very long time now. But one point he did mention is the fact that, and I need to mention this fact that, this is not something that just started within the last 5, 10, 15 years. We have had problems with drugs in our communities, urban communities, since the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. And I'm glad to see we have leadership in the state of Connecticut today that wanted to address this problem as a public health issue.
Ferraro,
I applaud you, big guy, for speaking the truth. And I'm glad we're going to speak the truth as we continue on and fight this epidemic and not forget it about the other ones that we lost on this trail. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Representative.